Yo, 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 what's going on, everybody? This is your girl, Crunk Girl 711 from PAX East 2013, Boston. I'm here today with the developers of Secret Ponchos, who just showed me a crazy, crazy game. Like, I just got a hands-on, and it's so much fun. And I just found out it's coming to the PS4, so what do you have to say about that?
Oh, we're really excited to launch on PS4. We just wanted to make a fun game that's, like, addictive, competitive, and just, you know, high adrenaline.
I see it's in the West. Like, what made y'all pick that type of atmosphere? You don't see a lot of games that are in the West with, like, a top-down view. You mostly see a lot of first-person shooters and stuff like that. So.
Yeah, we just wanted to do something original. You know, we're big fans of the spaghetti Western films. We used to just listen to a lot of the music, and we just thought one day we were listening to the music playing Soul Calibur at the same time by Fluke, and we're like, why don't we make a fighting game that's a spaghetti Western game?
So basically that's where y'all got the whole Matador and all that stuff from character-wise?
Yeah, you know, it's just interesting. When you have a new genre that's different, you just get inspired from that genre and you get a bunch of new ideas for characters. Like, you know, and I don't know if there's ever been a Matador that fights gunfighters in the game before, so hopefully, you know, some original stuff comes out of it. Fast and fluid with dual pistols and has dynamite as the secondary weapon. You know, there's the old guy who's just, you know, the reason he's so old is because he's a survivor, you know, and so he's really precision and you don't miss, you try not to miss with him, but he does a lot of damage. You get the Civil War, you know, guy, the deserter, and he's got a bayonet and a big shotgun, he's a big tanky guy. So you get all these different kind of characters. They're all outlaws, they all have bounties on their head, and that's kind of what connects them all in this universe.
So today at PAX, we played one level. How many other levels will there be? And I think we play co-op or against each other. How many other different game modes will there be, like free-for-all and stuff like that?
Yeah, so there's, what we saw here is 8-player free-for-all. The game supports split screen, so you can even have a buddy come over and go online together as a team. There's team combat, so you can fight 4 versus 4, 2 versus 2, one-on-one fights too. So there's a lot of different game modes that have different amounts of players.
Okay, so that's really good, people. So for the ones who really don't play online like that, they can have a friend to come over and play split screen, because you don't really see a lot of new split screen games right now on the new next-gen consoles. So what about the whole attributes? I think I picked up like stamina, and is there like a whole bunch of collectibles that you're picking up around the world as you go?
Yeah, one of the game modes, the free-for-all mode, actually has power-ups like double damage, extra stamina, that kind of stuff, health pack pickups. It just helps you when you're running around taking bullets, you know, it just gives you that last little bit of survivability. Two guys are running for a health pack, one of them's going to get it, so.
What is the hardest thing to get with this game, learning curve-wise, or is it just like a fun game, just pick up and go?
You know, it's fun. We didn't want to have a huge, like make it like some huge technical barrier to people learning it. So hopefully when people get their hands on it at shows like PAX, you know, we watch if they're having fun within a few minutes of playing. And then once they're having fun, just shooting, reloading, dive rolling, taking cover, then they got the basics down. Then we start layering on other moves. So every character has a lot of depth. But the good thing is you don't feel like crap if you don't know all those moves. You can have fun with the basics.
Okay. So do y'all have like a release date or a window where y'all gonna come out on the PS4?
Yeah, on PS4 we're coming out in fall, and you know, a lot of people have been asking for a PC game and pushing for that. We're actually gonna be launching on Early Access, and that's gonna be as close as maybe 6 to 8 weeks, and we're gonna have that. So for people who really wanna get their hands on it, they can get it on Early Access and help us, you know, tune the game together and push it to final, and then it's gonna hit PS4.
No. Okay. For sure, man. It was so nice meeting you. I love playing your game, I can't wait to get my hands on it. Definitely check this game out, y'all. If you're at PAX right now, check it out. If not, get it in the fall, and it's coming soon. It's your girl, Crunk Girl 711, and I'm out. Holla.